I guess I just landed wrong and I didn't see where I was landing, so that's kind of what caused the injury. But I kind of felt like stuff like this doesn't just happen for no reason, you know, there's a reason behind everything. So I'll soon to find out what the reason is going to be, but it's just a process that I'm ready for, you know.
The precarious situation for college athletes who get injured. I'm Marcus Mabry for the New York Times. Jason Stallman is the sports editor, and he joins me now. Jason, thanks for coming up.
Hi, Marcus.
So as far as we know, as far as we understand from our reporting right now, Kevin Ware is being well cared for, but that's not the case for many college athletes. Tell us about our story.
Right, so this issue with Kevin Ware, who sustained the very gruesome leg injury on Sunday, has stirred the debate all over again about the treatment of college athletes. Louisville and the NCAA say that they have insurance policies that take care of him quite well right now. He was taken to the hospital, he had surgery. But critics of college sports raise the question of what happens years from now, once he's out of school, if he has recurring problems with this injury, arthritis or anything else. Mm-hmm. Once he's away from the school, who's on the hook for the medical bills? From our understanding, the university health insurance policy does not cover a student athlete once he's gone.
And so what, and also these are, as you said, student athletes. These are not professionals. They are not entitled to workman's compensation, because this, as we would be in our jobs, because these are on jobs. These are amateurs. So what happens at smaller schools, for instance, where there's not a big Louisville that makes millions of dollars on big sports programs?
The workers' compensation issue is a key part of this. As you said, if an employee sustains an injury in the workplace, the employer's responsible for paying for the rehabilitation and the health costs of that. The NCAA athletes are not considered employees, although they might aid in helping the universities generate a lot of money, especially at an event like the NCAA tournament.
These are not nonprofit programs, these sports programs.
That's how they consider themselves, so the athletes are not under workers' compensation law.
So what are there efforts to change the system?
There certainly are. There are advocacy groups that are trying to lobby on behalf of the student athletes. And the state of California, even last year, their state legislature passed a bill that would take some steps into providing further benefits for student athletes when they sustain injuries while playing for a university.
All right. Well, Jason, thanks for coming up.
Thank you, Marcus.
That's all for now. I'm Marcus Mabry for the New York Times.